saying yes, please be seated. Student activities at North Penn High School and a parent of the class of 2001. Welcome to Senior Reflections. 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 Reflections is a very special program at North Penn High School. It is different from all of the other aspects of our graduation season. Reflections was created by the class of 1989, and for the past 12 years has been an opportunity for our graduating seniors, their parents and guardians, relatives and friends, to focus on the relationships that they have cherished over the past 17, 18, or even 19 years. We know that you will appreciate the presentations and the performances of our seniors as they reflect on friends and family and faculty who have impacted on their lives. In this spirit, we ask that you not call out or even applaud during or at the conclusion of each segment of the program. But, on the other hand, simply sit back and enjoy the moment together so that each of the performances and each of the comments made and segments can be appreciated and reflected upon in the spirit in which they are given. We will certainly all have time to show our appreciation and our enthusiasm for our seniors at the conclusion of this evening's program. The members of the class of 2001, thank you for your cooperation as adults, and we know as members of the class of 2001, you will reflect that spirit of good listening and appreciation for that which each and every one of your peers is doing here on stage. As we reflect, there are memories of both joy and sadness. We begin this program this evening by pausing for a moment of silence to reflect on the memory of Nate Robeson, a former member of this class who was tragically taken from us this past weekend. Could we observe a moment of silence, please? It is now my pleasure to introduce Lindsay Whitmer with our first reflection of the evening.
Two years ago, we stepped into North Penn High School. No longer were we freshmen. We had a new attitude. We had experience, or so we thought. We were individuals seeking to do well, to find our identities, to find our place. We opened our lockers for the first time and walked through the enormous halls of this school, perplexed by the size, but full of excitement about how awesome it was to be in high school. We knew it would be different, but we never realized how much would actually change. 2 years ago, we found a group of friends. We even found a best friend. We went to our first winter ball, had a crush on a cute upperclassman, and sometimes were talked to by the older, more mature people of our new school. We went to Sweet 16 parties, tried out for sports teams, found some kind of niche in the school. Okay, so maybe we sneakily lied to our parents to go to that party, or to do our own partying, or even to sleep over that boyfriend or girlfriend's house. It's funny to think of how mature we thought we were. It's funny to remember going to our first high school football game. I think that the sound of the band playing will forever remind me of those Friday nights. 2 years ago, we couldn't wait to get older. We couldn't wait until we were the upperclassmen and to have that extra bit of freedom. We wanted to be the ones who were looked up to, and even the ones who were sometimes feared. 1 year ago, we became upperclassmen. We began to realize that we were growing up. We got our licenses, we were driving to school events, and we were doing things we never thought we'd get the chance to do. We were doing things with that little bit of extra freedom, and sometimes our parents knew what we were doing because of the trust that we slowly began to gain. 1 year ago, we realized who our true friends were and started to really value the time spent with them. We found a place to fit in, yet we were still looking for something else. We began thinking about college and life after high school, still believing it was all too far away. We had our junior prom, got our class rings, and realized that time does fly. But 1 year ago, we still couldn't wait to get older. We couldn't wait to gain that freedom and responsibility of a senior. This year, we entered high school as seniors. We had senioritis before class even started. Some of us got to leave school early, and we all got our own parking spots. We began to not even care about whether or not we were late. Everything we did this year was our last. Our last homecoming, our last football game, our last season in a sport, our actual last birthday at home. This past year, we realized that high school was nothing we expected. Senior year, some of us had the same best friends since kindergarten, and some of us were with a new group of friends. Either way, these friends and the time spent with them were what kept us sane. We started applying for colleges near and far, getting accepted and rejected. No matter how much stress we felt upon our backs, we always had a way out. We could always turn to our friends to just have fun and forget about life after high school. Still, we may not fully be sure of what we want to do. We realize now that some of us will no longer have the comfort of home within three months, and less than that for others. We will be making those decisions to spend the night with friends or to party. As time has passed, some of us are finally realizing that maybe we could have waited to grow up, to be faced with some of those decisions. We realize now that somehow time has slipped away from us, and soon we will say goodbye to our friends, our family, our room, everything we've known as home. Soon we will graduate and sit with our friends for the last time. It may be the last time you see that not-so-well-known kid who sat behind you in class you just love to talk to. It may be the last time you see that fair girl you had a crush on for the past 4 years that you came to school every day just to see. It may be the last time you're forced to see your enemies or to look at a bully. It may be the last opportunity you have to look at the people who have taught us some of the most valuable lessons and touched us the most. It will be the last time we sit together and are recognized as the North Penn Class of 2001. Now, we are preparing to start over, getting sad about what we will leave behind, yet getting anxious to move on. We are realizing how important our best friends are and just how much fun we really have had. We may even wish we were younger or wish we would have taken time to sit back and enjoy it. In 1 year, we will return as different people. We will have experienced freedom, dorm life, ate campus food, met new friends. We will have joined a club, maybe a frat or sorority, done something new. We will have picked our majors, changed them, passed and failed at things. We will know a lot more about ourselves and what we want to become. We will look back on memories, even though we will have created new ones. We may miss our old friends and wonder how they are all doing, each in their own spots, as we will all be searching for the same things. Tonight, look at the faces around you and know that these people, friends or not, will be the ones who will forever share in your memories of high school. Come back in about 3 years, and sorry to say, there won't be a lot of people left that know who you are. Those people won't know your accomplishments and even your failures. Only the people that you've experienced these things with, your family, your teachers, your friends, will know. These people are who sit with you tonight. In 1 year, those memories, those thoughts, will all be the same, because tomorrow we will graduate, and the memories of high school are sealed, done with. But they'll never go away. Amidst this changing time, that may be hard to listen to, but it's true. The memories will never, ever go away.
Good evening. I'm Mark Weinstein.
And I'm Diana Maggi.
And we are the co-chairs of the 2001 Reflections. We want to welcome all the faculty, friends, family, and members of the class of 2001.
What you will see tonight is just a small sampling of the many memories our class has experienced.
Tonight, your friends may not be on stage, and maybe the experience happened a little bit differently, but we can all appreciate the memories they represent.
So join us, for now, it's time to show our true colors.
Enjoy the program.
inside. Have him with me always. There's a kid inside. Walking down old high school hallways. There's a kid inside. At a desk, at a dance, in the halls, in the showers. There's a kid inside to this very day. And he makes a try for the high-pop fly that I fumbled one September. And he makes a fuss over some A-plus that I shouldn't still remember. And he goes along, getting hurt, getting mad, fighting fights that are over. And unless I'm strong, all my senses are carried away. I can feel my hand, my trembling hand, on Michelle's and Cora's sweater. I can hear my band, that awful band, only now it sounds much better. I can see the kid I used to be, on the stage, on the field, on the lunch line. I can feel him tugging at me. Every time I think I don't care, I blink, and he's there again. He's there again. Fighting ancient wrongs, humming old hit songs in my head. Singing, come along, come along, come along for the ride. To a time and place I could not forget if I tried. There again, he's there again. And I never know if the breeze will blow with the rush of old sensations. Why the kids should wake and my heart should ache every time I smell carnations. Something rings a bell, anything at all. All it takes is a slam of a locker, or the switch from summer to fall. A change of season seems barely reason, but there it goes again. Humming his songs, fighting ancient wrongs, humming old hit songs in my head. Singing, come along, come along, come along for the ride. To a time and place I could not forget if I tried. There he goes again, humming his songs.
Screaming children with red, pink, and blue backpacks, sitting three in a seat on the big yellow bluebird. They sit in chairs merely a foot from the carpet, trying so hard not to lean back and get in trouble. So many hold their desktops open with their heads, looking for some paper. Freshly sharpened pencils and little nimble fingers, desperately trying to scribe so perfectly their little names between those huge red and green lines. Waxy scents of Crayola crayons permeate the classroom air. Little worries of who's got the purple crayon race through their innocent minds, oblivious of what is to come.
What shirt matches his pants? What letter day is it? Who am I going with to the dance? You ask yourself today, you still don't know tomorrow. No longer does the purple crayon matter. It's blue or black ink only. You type your name now on the head of a 10-page comp while sitting in a chair that comes with a desk. Can't lean back now. You felt peer pressure would never come until your best friend has a drug problem. Dare to keep kids off drugs. Dare to come to school. Armed intruder drills, near recess. You slam your locker, load your books into a friend's car, knowing what you had.
18-year-old seniors sitting side by side in identical blue gowns, preparing for the future. They sit in auditorium chairs, colored mustard yellow and olive green, trying so hard not to cause a ruckus, trying so hard not to cry. Tears well up in reflective eyes, like shining moonlit lakes, preparing for the future.
What am I taking to college?
I'm taking my memories and my youthful ambitions.
Who will I meet?
I'll meet people who will impact me for the rest of my life.
What will I remember from North Penn?
I'll remember the commencement means beginning.
What do I do if I feel homesick, worthless, or insecure?
I'll hold my tassel, admiring the gleaming 2001, and be proud that I graduated from North Penn, and relieved that I remembered to remove my tassel before throwing my cap.
I'll step off the field and hug my friends,
smiling for what I've done.
I'd give anything to rebuild the bridges I burned, but those were
tight to Daddy's hand, watching mine disappear in his. Someday, maybe we'll have a perfect fit. Then one day I'll wear a ring. He'll hold it till the day it grows cold. When will I grow old? I want to know when I can wear a pretty dress for my prom, and when will my handsome prince arrive? My future is unwarranted, and my journey is long. But there's something more than the journey. The challenge it is to get there seems so far away. But I'll always have what I have now.
What do I have right now? I feel in the middle of my journey, destination in sight, but still stuck in this moment known as high school. I remember when I was a little girl and this stage felt so long away. I couldn't wait to grow up. Maybe I grew up too fast. Did I try to let go of my parents too soon? Possibly I knew them more than I thought. After all, on the grand scale of my life, these 3 years of high school are only a moment. My parents will be with me forever, but will my friends?
Andrea will always be my best friend. Even when we're in high school, we'll still pick daisies at recess and ride our bikes on Saturdays. And when we get to high school, I'm gonna marry James, cutest boy in the second grade. And Andrea will be my bridesmaid. I'll wear high-heeled shoes and my rainbow bright crown, and Daddy will be there holding my hand. Then I'll be a doctor and wear a cool lab coat. I just can't wait to grow up.
Sometimes I wish I could be a little girl again. Life was so simple. My biggest anxiety I can remember was getting my first bad grade, a B in handwriting. And when I got in a fight with my best friend, I would just write a little note saying, "Are you mad at me? Check yes or check no." And after a few messages, everything was okay. When I go away, I will miss my friends so much. Will they miss me? I don't know, nothing seems concrete.
No more nap time, no more timeouts. My big sister will be in college and I'll be home all by myself. Mommy will let me drive to McDonald's every day. And I'm gonna travel around the world. I'll have my own locker at school and I can carry my purse everywhere. I'll be the best student and I'll never be bad. I promise Mr. Dare Officer never to do drugs or drink alcohol. Nope, not ever. But I have such a long way to go. And here I am, 8 years old.
No more 8-period school day. No more detentions, no more curfew. College will be great. Will I handle the pressure? I have made many mistakes under the shelter of my parents. What will I be like on my own? I want to set so many goals. I know I have drive and I need to see everything and to gain as much knowledge as possible. I need to find myself. I need to let go of the past but hold on to my memories. So many challenges and I'm only 18.
Goodbye,
high school.
Too many days I entered these halls with eyes weary and tired and a brain unwilling to learn.
I took for granted that one building could be the root of my life, my friends, and now my memories.
I would never have guessed the course which I am on now.
When I came here, I didn't know many of my now closest friends.
When I entered a scared and nervous sophomore, I didn't even know who I was, let alone who I wanted to be.
The whole evolution of adolescence is the most windy and bumpy process I think exists.
There are times when your friends are everything to you.
And there are times when you feel like you can only count on yourself, and it feels lonely but makes you stronger and more independent.
But while all this stuff known as life is happening, we neglect to realize
time is flying faster than you can grasp.
Faster.
Faster.
Faster than ever.
Maybe this place wasn't as bad as we thought.
This pastime known as high school will be fixed in our memories forever.
Our laughs
and footsteps
will echo in these halls.
Will echo in these halls.
Until those who follow us
in the same yet different ways
arrive to wash them away.
Dear Mama and Daddy, tomorrow I will be graduating from high school. I am sitting before you today, an 18-year-old young woman, ready to start my own life. I have worked for the past 13 years in school to go to an excellent college where I will learn beyond my expectations. I have lived in your house, eaten your food, worn your clothing, and been your child. Now I'm ready to become my own woman. But when I think about it, my own woman includes so much of each of you. My mother's hair, my father's feet, my mother's eyes, my father's smile, my mother's need for organization, my father's perfectionism, my mother's persistence, and the leader inside my father. They're all meshed together to make me, yet they are all a piece of you. I strive to become a different person so I won't turn into my parents, like so many say. But to tell you the truth, I would be happy to become a person like the two of you. You've taught me everything that I need to know to become a person that others admire. I have learned by watching you, learn by listening to you, and learn by obeying you what is expected of me. And through the things you have taught me, I've become a person that I respect. I'm proud of the woman I've become. I have friends that I love and that love me. I have accomplishments that have exceeded my dreams. I have opportunities ahead of me that have been given to me by you. I'm a person that cares about others, that works hard to get what I want, and that pushes for the best out of myself. Even though these qualities and so many more make up me, I still strive to be a better person. Deep inside, I strive to be more like my parents, more like you. Mom, you're an angel sent from God. Your caring and loving nature has guided me to be the compassionate person I am. Through your disease, I've been exposed to so many admirable characteristics about you. Your everlasting strength and perseverance has been an inspiration to me. You have fought this disease with everything inside of you, and even on bad days, you seem to put on a smile just to prove that you can make it through. The friends that surround you day to day not only show that you have wonderful, caring supporters, but also that you are the type of person that people want to share their time with. You are the type of person that people want to give up their own activities to help you. You are the type of person that people care about, that people love, and that people want to be friends with. I have learned just over this past year that you are not only a superb mother that has given up her life for her children, but also a beautiful, amazing person. A real person that has her own thoughts and emotions in her own life. You are a strong woman who has made her way through the world on her own. You have learned to love, to give selflessly, and to be a role model to your children. I thank you, Mommy, for being you, for being such a wonderful mother. And Daddy, my own father, a man who is the epitome of strength and courage, a man that has held our whole family together in the hard times, a man who has been the cornerstone of the family from the beginning. How can I begin to praise a person that I have looked up to my whole entire life? There are no words. I was always Daddy's baby right from the start. It made me laugh when there were tears streaming down my face. Do you remember the tear jar? I was the target of your playful ridicule and teasing, but somehow I always knew it was your way of telling me you loved me. I have looked to you in times of need, knowing that you would always be there to encourage me, to guide me, to find what I wanted, and to push me to my limits. I found that you too have thoughts and emotions that make you a person outside of being my father. You work hard day in and day out to provide for us, to give us everything that you can, to give us the best, and to show us the world. I admire everything that you are and everything that you have done. I'm so proud to call you my father. I thank you, Daddy, for being you, for being such a wonderful father. And to my parents as a whole, you have shown me what it is like to truly love a person and to give yourself up for that person. You have shown me the beauties of life and the world you live in. You've shown me how to be myself, even in the times where it is most difficult. You've been my guiding light through everything, and I leaned on you for every decision and every milestone through my life. You have been my everything. But as I sit here today, I know that you have taught me what I need to know to move on. I will take everything with me so I can build on my existing knowledge to become a grown woman. But I know that all I ever need to know that is worth anything, I have learned from my wonderful parents. And if I search my whole life, I will never find a man as wonderful as my father. And if I work for all the years ahead, I will never live to be half the woman my mother is. As I am receiving my diploma tomorrow, I will be thinking of you. Thank you, Mommy and Daddy. I love you.
It takes a lot to know what is love. It's not the big things, but the little things that can mean enough. Not a prayer's to get me through. And there is never a day that passes by I don't think of you. You were always there for me. Pushing me and guiding me always to succeed.
You showed me
when I was young just how to grow.
You showed me
everything that I should know.
You showed me
just how to walk without your hands. 'Cause Mom, you always were the perfect fan.
tall grass bend into leaning. Suddenly the raindrops that fall have a meaning, sprinkling the scene, makes it all clean. Maybe there's a chance for me to go back now that I would be nice to be back home where there's love and affection. And just maybe I can convince time to slow up, giving me enough time for my life to grow up. Time be my friend. Let me start again. I'm going. I have had my mind spun around in space, and yet I watched it growing. Whoa, if you're listening, God, please don't make it hard to know if we should believe what we see. Tell us, should we try and stay? Or should we run away? Or would it be better just to
this year, so much emphasis has been put on our future, and tonight gives us a chance to look back. Not just back at the memories from North Penn High School, or even at whichever middle school you went to, but a chance to look back at the memories from elementary school. When you think about it, so much of who we are today was shaped by so much of what there was back then. When you think about it, the things we find the funniest today are still the things that we saw on TV when we were 7 or 8. And we still sing along with all the 80s music when it comes on the radio. I mean, it was a ridiculous decade, but you know you grew up in the 80s if.
You played Mall Madness and Girl Talk. You ever earned a pair of jelly shoes.
You could sing the rap to the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yeah.
If you yearned to be a member of the Babysitter's Club and tried to start a club of your own.
You remember going to the skating rink before there were inline skates.
You own those little strawberry shortcake scented dolls.
The Crypt Keeper really freaked you out.
You ever watched Fraggle Rock?
You remember Vicky the Robot?
You remember watching both Gremlins movies?
You thought your childhood friends would never leave you because you exchanged friendship bracelets.
You wore biker shorts under your skirts and felt stylish.
You remember reading Kool-Aid Man comics and saving Kool-Aid points.
you ever ended your sentence with, psych.
You remember Rainbow Bright, My Little Pony.
You remember Popples.
You remember the Gimp Fag.
You saw the California Raisins Christmas Claymation Special.
After you saw Pee-wee's Big Adventure, you couldn't stop saying, I know you are, but what am I?
You had a glow warmer, watched the cartoons.
You remember boomboxes instead of CD players.
You know not to mix pop rocks and soda.
You remember dancing along with the Bangles and
walk like an Egyptian.
You remember reading Tales of Fourth Grade Nothing and all the Ramona books.
You remember Punky Brewster.
You got super excited when it was Oregon Trail Day in your computer class.
You had plastic streamers on the handlebars of your bike.
Your mother wouldn't let you have garbage pail kids.
M.C. Hammer.
You saw the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on the big screen.
You remember Zack Attack from Saved by the Bell.
You wear socks over tights with high top Reeboks.
Thundercats, home!
Not at the end of every statement you made.
You took a lunch pail to school.
You remember Alf, the furry brown alien.
You ever pondered why Smurfette was the only female Smurf?
You thought She-Ra and He-Man should hook up.
You remember Mr. Belvedere.
You remember the beginning of New Kids on the Block.
You had or went to a birthday party at McDonald's.
You have played with the Skip It.
You can sing the entire theme song to DuckTales.
You wanted to change your name to Gem in kindergarten.
Barbie and the Rockers were your favorite band.
You remember the Wayans Brothers debut on In Living Color.
You know the profound meaning of wax on, wax on.
Your ponytail on the side of your head.
You remember Michael J. Fox and Family Ties and Back to the Future.
You remember watching The Cosby Show.
You remember Transformers and G.I. Joes.
Slap bracelets.
You wanted to be a Goonie.
You got seriously injured on a slip and slide.
You remember watching TV and thinking Doogie Howser was really hot.
You made your mom buy you one of those cool clips that would hold your shirt in a knot on the side.
You remember Heathcliff the orange cat.
You solved the Rubik's Cube by peeling off the stickers.
Jesse's hit song.
If every word I said could make you laugh, I'd talk forever.
Miss Mary Mac, all dressed in black.
You remember the large amount of hairspray used.
You remember I've fallen and I can't get up.
You played the game WASH with friends in school.
We hope that everything you remember tonight has brought back at least a couple of memories from growing up. I mean, we realize that the 80s were probably the most ridiculous decade this country has ever seen, but you have to admit, we definitely enjoyed it.
Memories, life, happiness, sorrow. Our lives change come tomorrow. We've shared days, months, and years. We've shared our triumphs, loves, and fears. We've laughed and we've cried. We've done and we've tried.
When we needed someone, we knew who to turn to. When we wanted fun, late nights and Perkins from 10 to 2.
Some of us had many friends, some of us one or few. It really didn't matter who, just as long as we knew they were true.
Some friends may come and go, some may stay till the end. But as long as you're always true,
I'm proud to call you friend.
To the doctor, I ran to the mountains. I looked to the children, and I tried. choice but to sit it out or dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope
someone who would sweep me off my feet and ease my fears. Needless to say, when I came to North Bend High School, I was in deep search of my hero-type figure. Little did I know what I would discover. Well, I'm here to tell you that in order to find what I was looking for, I had to fail many times. And I stand before you tonight not knowing whether I truly found what I was looking for. But what I can tell you and what I can remember is that feeling of butterflies when that certain someone says hi to you as they pass you in the crowded hallways. Or that feeling of anticipation as you wait for your dance date to arrive. At that time, those guys were my hero figures. Or think about those times when you ace that test. Or when you win that football game of a lifetime, even if it is against a mediocre team. Those are the times when you feel invincible to the world and nothing can push you off the mountain that you've struggled to climb. And then, well, I got shoved off and back to my reality. Then came the point of emptiness, and there is no butterfly feeling. And eventually, the dance must come to an end. And sorry to say, Mom, but how could I ever forget the 4 out of 50 on that math test? Or shall I even dare to mention North Penn's attempts to beat the almighty CB West? These were the times when I didn't want to get back up. And heck, I didn't even want to get out of bed. But one day, you eventually have to. Or your mother makes you, whichever comes first. And then it hit me. I realized who had been with me all along. My friends and my family. No matter what state I had been in, they were there. No matter what mood or situation I had in my life, at that moment, they never left my side. They knew when I was down, and they did what they could. Even if it meant just calling to go out with me or handing me a tissue. Or for that matter, 20 tissues. Or maybe it was perhaps helping me to understand that cosine tangent thing. Then there were the times when all you really need is a hug. They were always there for that reason. These are the people in my life that have been my heroes time and time again. And because of their heroic strength, if you will, I was a better person. Now this heroic strength came in many forms, such as the advice they gave and the small things, the times when we laughed till we cried, and the fashion advice, and of course, who could forget those late nights? And the football games, what more can I say? It was those moments that made my high school experience one to remember. Not to mention that because of these heroes, I'm here for tomorrow. And the funny thing is that a majority of these times, we weren't in school. Now I know that all of us at one point will have a hero, but just remember that heroes come in many forms, and sometimes you look so far beyond the one that you want to be your hero, you miss the ones that are already there. So to my heroes, my friends, and my family, I say thanks for the journey. I hope you will stick by me for the next phase. Hold on, it's certainly going to be an interesting one.
realize that this is the best day of my life ever.
There were times when I wondered if I would make it to today. And because I did, I'm going to celebrate.
Today I'm going to celebrate what an unbelievable life I've had so far. The accomplishments, the many blessings, and yes, even the hardships, because they have served to make me stronger. I will go through this day with my head held high and a happy heart. I will marvel at God's seemingly simple gifts, the morning dew, the sun, the clouds, the trees, the flowers, the birds. Today, none of these miraculous creations will escape my notice.
Today, I will share my excitement for life with other people. I'll make someone smile. I'll go out of my way to perform an unexpected act of kindness for someone I don't even know. Today, I'll give a sincere compliment to someone who seems down. I'll tell a child just how special he is. And I'll tell someone I love just how deeply I care for him and how much he means to me.
Today is the day I quit worrying about what I don't have and start being grateful for all the wonderful things God has already given me. I'll remember that things will work out just fine and not to worry.
And tonight, before I go to sleep, I'll go outside and raise my eyes to the heavens.
I will remember those people that had made me laugh when I was crying.
I'll remember those who smiled at me in the hall even though they didn't know my name.
As we all journey into life after this night, I'll remember all those who have been a part of my life.
I will sleep the sleep of a contented child, excited with expectation, because tomorrow is going to be the best day of my life.
Ever.
When I think back on these times and the dreams we left behind, I'll be glad cause I was blessed to get to have you in my life. When I look back on these days, I look and see your face. You were right there for me. In my heart, the Lord.
So good. In kindergarten, your idea of a best friend was the person who let you have the red crown when all that was left was the ugly brown one.
In first grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who went to the bathroom with you and held your hand as you walked through the scary halls.
In second grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who helped you stand up to the class bully.
In third grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who shared their lunch with you when you forgot yours on the bus.
In fourth grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who's willing to switch square dancing partners in gym so you wouldn't have to be stuck with nasty Nick or smelly Susan.
In fifth grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who saved a seat on the back of the bus for you.
In sixth grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who went up to Nick or Susan, your new crush, and asked them to dance with you so that if they said no, you wouldn't have to be embarrassed.
In seventh grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who let you copy the social studies homework from the night before.
In eighth grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who helped you pack up your stuffed animals and old baseballs, but didn't laugh at you when you finished and broke into tears.
In ninth grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who would go to a party thrown by a senior so that you wouldn't be the only freshman there.
In 10th grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who changed their schedule so you would have someone to sit with at lunch.
In 11th grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who gave you rides in their new car, convinced your parents you shouldn't be grounded, and consoled you when you broke up with Nick or Susan.
In 12th grade, your idea of a best friend was the person that helped you pick out a college, assured you that you'd get into that college, helped you deal with your parents who were having a hard time adjusting to the idea of letting you go, and at graduation was the person who was crying on the inside, but somehow managed to give you the biggest smile one could possibly give as they congratulated you.
The summer after 12th grade, your idea of a best friend was the person who helped you clean up from the big party, helped you sneak out of the house when you just couldn't deal with your parents, assured you that now that you were back together with Nick or Susan, you could make it through anything, helped you look through blurry eyes at 18 years of memories you were leaving behind, and most importantly, sent you off to college knowing you were loved.
In the future, your idea of a best friend will still be the person who gives you the better of the two choices, holds your hand when you are scared, helps you fight off those who try to take advantage of you, thinks of you when you're not there, helps you forget the past, but understands when you need to hold on to it for a little longer, stays with you so that you have confidence, helps you deal with the pressure from others,
smiles when you are sad,
helps you become a better person,
and most importantly,
loves you.
Oh, the Places You'll Go, by Dr. Seuss. Congratulations! Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. You have brains in your head. You got feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. And you are the guy who decides where you go.
You look up and down the streets, look them over with care. About some you will say, I don't choose to go there. With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not so good street. And you may not find any you want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town. It's opener there, in the wide open air.
Out there, things can happen, and frequently do, to people as brainy and footsie as you. And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew, just go right along, you'll start happening too.
Oh, the places you'll go. You'll be on your way up, you'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have the speed. You'll pass the whole gang and you'll soon take the lead. Wherever you fly, you'll be best of the best. Wherever you go, you'll top all the rest.
Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't. I'm sorry to say so, but sadly, it's true. The bang-ups, the hang-ups, can happen to you. You can get all hung up in a prickly perch, your gang will fly on, you'll left in a lurch. When you come down from that lurch with an unpleasant bump, and the chances are then that you'll be in a slump. And when you're in a slump, you're not in for much fun. Unslumping yourself is not easy to be done.
You will come to a place where the streets are not marked. Some windows are lighted, but mostly they're dark. A place you can sprain with your elbow and chin. Do you dare to stay out? Do you dare to go in? How much can you lose? How much can you win? And if you go in, should you turn left, turn right, or right three quarters, or maybe not quite? Or go around back and sneak in from behind? Simple it's not, I'm afraid you will find. From mind maker upper to make up his mind. You can get so confused you'll start into race down long wiggled roads at a breakneck pace. And grind on for miles across weirdish wild space, headed, I fear, towards the most useless place, the waiting place.
For people just waiting. Waiting for a train to go, or a bus to come, or the plane to go, or the mail to come, or the rain to go, or the phone to ring, or the snow to snow, or waiting around for a yes or a no, or waiting for their hair to grow. Everyone is just waiting. Waiting for the fish to bite, or waiting for the wind to fly a kite, or waiting around for a Friday night, or waiting perhaps for their Uncle Jake, or a pot to boil, or a better break, or a string of pearls, or a pair of pants, or a wig with curls, or another chance. Everyone is just waiting.
No, that's not for you. Somehow you'll escape all that waiting and staying. You'll find the bright places where boom bands are playing. With banner flip flapping once more, you'll ride high, ready for anything under the sky. Ready because you're that kind of guy. Oh, the places you'll go. There is fun to be done, there are points to be scored, there are games to be won. And the magical things you can do with that ball will make you the winningest winner of all. Fame. You'll be as famous can be, with the whole wide world watching you win on TV.
Except when they don't, because sometimes they won't. I'm afraid that sometimes you'll play lonely games too. Games you can't win, because you'll play against you. All alone, whether you like it or not, alone will be something you'll be quite a lot. And when you're alone, there's a very good chance you'll meet things that scare you right out of your pants. There are some down the road between hither and yon that can scare you so much you'll want to go on.
But on you will go, though the weather be foul. On you will go, though your enemies prowl. On you will go, though the hacking cracks howl. Onward up many a frightening creek, though your arms may get sore and your sneakers may leak. On and on you will hike, and I know you'll hike far, and face up to your problems, whatever they are.
You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step, to have a great care and great tact. And remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous in death, and never mix up your right foot with your left. Oh, the...
That's not there.
Don't ring my bird. Oh, the places you'll go. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains.
So, be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray, or Mordecai Alley than Alan O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
Go Sixers.
Just slips away, and you're left with yes. yesterday, left with the memories. I'll always think of you and smile and be happy for the time I had you with you and you were there.
Past 17, 18, 19 years of our lives together as parents and children, there are many memories that rush through our minds. One of the fondest memories is the time spent reading bedtime stories. Tonight, we would like to share with you a new bedtime story entitled, Yay You. Moving up, moving out, moving on. Written by Sandra Boynton, especially for the graduates of the class of 2001. As parents, we dedicate it to Courtney and Erica, Greg, Lynn, Matt, Maya, and Rachel. Yay you. You did it. You're done. You made it. You're through.
Oh, what a great moment. Now what will you do?
There are so many choices. The world is immense. Take a good look around and decide what makes sense.
Some like to go fast.
Some like to go slow.
Some like to get going however they go.
Some strive to be peaceful and joyful and wise.
Some choose to just ponder the size of their thighs.
So look north.
And look south.
Look ahead.
Look behind.
Stare into the mirror.
What now? What do you find?
Should you live where it's cold?
Should you live where it's hot?
Do you want to be terribly busy?
Or not?
You need lots of friends.
Or only a few.
Would you like to have friends with a new point of view?
Is your mind moved by science?
Or does art move your soul?
Do you listen to rivers?
Or to great rock and roll? Do you long for adventure? Do you love to read maps?
Would you rather stay home with your chocolate, perhaps? You already have wit. You already have style. You have very kind eyes and a dazzling smile.
But now.
Hey, what's the hurry anyhow?
There are places to get to.
And projects to do.
People to talk with.
And lunches to chew.
Stopping a while is okay too.
And whatever you do, now or later, big or small, loud or quiet, whatever you do, don't worry, just try it. Whatever you do, whether near or so far,
we know you'll be great. You already are.
Something with each and every one of you. And the one reflection that I have of each one of you is your smile. Now that might sound really silly. You know all these common homerooms we had with you're the best, and you know you're all the best.
You're the best, Mr. Wilson.
Yeah.
Part of the problem. I'll tell you why. Because I wanted to come up here and I wanted to do something that I was the very best. So what do? Come up here and smile for 3 minutes? No. Okay, I'm going to tell you a story and it's going to fit in with the act I'm going to do tonight. Okay? I'm going to reflect back on when I was in seventh grade. I tried out for chorus. Everybody makes chorus. Except me. He said, sorry. So, a lot I've learned from then, and then I always sang a song to each one of my children, and they would listen. So I thought, well, at least somebody's listening. But as I'm listening tonight, and this is my lesson for all of you, is that if each of you take the three parts of this reflection, the three parts are your family, and I have my family back there for me tonight, my friend, Wendy and Laurie, if you could come up, I need a friend right now, my friends, and I have you, the school, my friends, my children. So I'm going to try something. I was practicing at home. I have two dogs. Well, my one dog is up, but I have two dogs, and I was practicing, and they started howling. Not very good, but this is a lesson because, you know, as you guys go out in this world, you're going to have things. I'm not good at this. I know that. I was told that in seventh grade. But you know what? If you have your friends, your family, and your school, you can do anything you want to do. And that's what I'm going to do with my two friends, with my family. Pop, I don't know how well you sing there, dear. And all of you, and I want you to help. I have to tell you, I called my dear friend Barbara Streisand because I always wanted to meet her. And she couldn't come tonight, so I don't have any background music. I don't have anything, but I have my two friends. I don't even have a piano player. We are going to sing a song called Sing a Song. And you need to help me with this. Now, some of you promised me you'd help me. Okay, come on out here. This is my friend Wendy and Laura. Okay, here we go. Ready? Now, you remember, I'm doing my best at something I'm not good at, but everybody's gonna help. Ready? Sing, sing a song. Sing out loud. Sing out strong. Sing of good things, not bad. Sing of happy, not sad. I don't hear you.
Her smile and spirit filled us with glee.
Jordana Mashori, hardworking and smart, her pumpkins and carnations painted happiness in the heart.
Ashami's enthusiasm and love of life inspired cabinet members in times of strife.
Sarah labored to receive parent and community support, made all those class expenses easier to afford.
Donna, a quiet member who never ever failed. Without her, there would have been no Disney or magazine sale.
Joy, confident in her ability to lead, she brought to Powderpuff and pushed players to succeed.
Gif filled our quota of only three men. His newsletters were excellent when he picked up a pen.
Elisa communicated our activities to the rest of the class, hanging colorful posters on the walls and on the glass.
Jessica, we want to praise her for class dinner's success. She accomplished this task with very little mess.
Megan, so lonely selling tickets in fourth period lunch. We want to thank you. Thank you a bunch.
Adrian, the t-shirts and mugs are finally here. Her hard work paid off. Let's give her a cheer.
Aileen, the behind the scenes and amongst the crowd, her rolling camera captured North Penn's spirit, always so proud.
Jen's artistic talent changed the image of Class CAD. Her showcases were timely and always so fab.
Morgan, day in, day out, she counted, organized, and planned. Our trip to Disney, and when we landed at Disney, we got our feet in the sand.
Diana's t-shirts and bags were so very stunning. We landed in Disney and hit the ground running.
Bridget's timeline showed us images from the past. Her creativity inspired prom memories to last, and please bring in your pictures for the timeline.
Neha's planning brought a theme of elegance to our last dance. We'll always remember the night's laughter, fun, and romance.
Diana, the junior prom was magical under her direction. The experience helped to create tonight's reflection.
Mark, always ready to lend a helping hand to others, he inspired us to show our own true colors.
Mrs. Wilson, into her work, she put her profound soul. We'll remember these years in her heart of gold.
Mr. Boardman, his dedication and focus always inspired us to act. Even as a new father, he kept our cabinet intact.
As any soon-to-be graduate knows, one does not reach this milestone on their own.
This evening is no different. Without the support of many dedicated volunteers, members of the class of 2001, faculty, staff, and administrators, an evening of this magnitude would not be possible.
We have a few thank yous. They're not all inclusive, but just a few that were really special. Art Addison and John Buckner, along with all the theater volunteers this evening.
Of course, our class of 2001 advisors, Mr. Tim Boardman and Mrs. Mary Wilson.
Principal of North Penn High School, Mr. Stephen E. Frederick, and Mr. John Pozzolo, Principal of the Class 2001.
Administrators and Vice Principals, Dr. Kim Callahan, Mr. Frank Perry, Mrs. Sandra Newman, Mrs. Patricia Krug, Mr. James Finnemeyer, and Mr. Don Ryan.
And of course, the lovely decorations would not be possible without the dedication of Steve Winterhalter, Sonia Berg, members of the Class of 2001 Officers, Cabinet, and the PowerPoint, some of which was done by Mr. Woodbury. We'd also like to thank MPTV for videotaping this evening. Please check the listings to see when it'll be on.
And also, thank you to all the parents for bringing us into this world.
And of course, the class of 2001. At this time, I'd like to call the podium Mr. John Pozzolo, class of 2001 vice president.
We forgot Sonia Berg, but we love her very much. Okay, she did the scrapbook.
Thank you. Family, friends, fellow faculty members, and especially you, the class of 2001. Friday night, as I walked outside in the courtyard, I was reminded that I had this opportunity to speak to you one last time. I was told that I was going to go into this and try to reflect over 3 years, which is extremely difficult. These are 3 years of very fond memories, memories I will take with me forever. Two words jumped into my mind, and the first word was thanks. Thanks for allowing me to share these memories with you. first week we spent in this school, as we navigated through the halls, many of you stopped to ask me direction. Little did you know, it was my first week at this school, and I was just as lost as you were. Thanks for that memory. Also, thanks for the memory of the first Friday night football game when we cheered the Knights on to victory, the dances that followed, the first sophomore dance, the winter ball, the junior prom, the senior prom. Thanks. Thanks especially for the trip to Disney, and oh, what a trip. Thanks, Mike, for not being lost in the Magic Kingdom that night. Thanks, Maggie, for making sure I got home. Thanks, Heidi, for all the help you gave me around the office. And to Jamie and Jamil, thanks for the beautiful mural you left me with. Mark, thanks for the challenge. Adrian, you were a challenge. But thanks most of all for the second word, and that is pride. You have made me feel so proud to be a part of your life. Many years ago, in 1955, a boy and his father watched the championship fight. And late in the fight, one of the combatants was beaten and bloody. And as the round ended, he made his way to the corner, stumbled to his stool. And the young boy looked at the father and said, "Dad, why doesn't he just quit?" And the father said, "Son, great champions never quit in the corner. They always answer the bell." Now you might ask, what does that have to do with me, the class of 2001? Well, ladies and gentlemen, you have answered every bell. When papers came due and chemistry tests were to be studied for, you answered the bell. When graduation project was due, you found a way. You answered that bell. You even answered the bell when you had some difficulties with your assistant principal. For that and all those memories, I am both thankful and proud. And as you go on in life and you face the many challenges that lie ahead, I wish you well. And I wish the wind always at your back and the rain fall gently on your face, because you were 3 years ago, you are tonight, and you will forever be the best.
I'm happy to be principal of North Penn High School, but I am so proud of the class of 2001. Tonight you have heard in song and prose reflections of the class of 2001. The success of the class is a matter of record. After all, it's the leadership of the seniors that went against the odds and had a very, very successful class trip to Florida. Beginning as sophomores and continuing through this year, the class of 2001 led the way in the record-setting Red Cross blood drives. Seniors worked closely with faculty members to initiate North Penn's involvement in the world of robotics. The boys' swimming team achieved the 200 consecutive win plateau, a mark that is unequaled in high school athletics across the nation. Through the vision of the class as juniors, the class of 2001 began a new tradition of hosting the junior prom back here in the high school and having a grand senior class night in the courtyard. It is the class of 2001 that is the true first class of the new millennium. Certainly each of the graduating seniors will remember proudly that it was their class who had the privilege of the state-mandated graduation project added to the list of requirements for graduation from high school. From the first day of school as a kindergarten student to the last bell of their senior year, the students in the class of 2001 have built a tradition of excellence. The foundation for this success was built with patience, understanding, and the guidance of the elementary school, middle school, and high school faculties and staff. Each step along the way, there was someone, a parent, a guardian, a friend, a teacher, secretary, or perhaps a member of the support staff to provide that extra lift, to add that extra special word of encouragement, or simply to be there. But again, that's not so much different than what will be needed for the next chapter in the lives of our graduates. Author Jane Goodall has rewritten a wonderful fable that illustrates how we depend on each other for help and support throughout our lives. And I would ask your indulgence as we briefly go through this particular book entitled The Eagle and the Wren. Once upon a time, long, long ago, as most fables begin, the birds got into an argument about who could fly the highest. "I can fly so high," said the skylark, "that I become just a tiny speck in the sky, and then I disappear altogether. You can only hear my voice, my beautiful song. I can fly the highest." "No, no, 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 no," said the dove. "I can fly the highest. I was sent by Noah to search for signs of the ending of the great flood. From high in the sky, I flew to pick the olive branch that has become a symbol of peace. I can fly the highest." "I can fly even higher," said the vulture. "I circle up and up and up until I can look down half the world. That's how I see my dinner. The animals who have died, I can fly the highest." "You are all wrong," said the majestic eagle. "I am the king of the birds. My wings are strong, my heart is great. I fly far above the world and look down to see all that is going on below. I can fly the highest." "Be silent, all of you," said the wise owl. "We'll have a contest for all of the birds. We will find out just how high each one of us can fly." So all the birds took to the air. There was a great flapping of wings and squawking and calling and hooting and croaking. Some of the birds really didn't fly very high at all. They quickly came back to the earth. They were a bit sad, but the ostrich welcomed them. "You have all done as well as nature intended," he said. "You have all wings, but each of you flies to a different height for a different purpose. After all," he added, "I can't fly, and I'm certainly not ashamed of that. I use my wings in the beautiful dance that wins me my bride." Some of the birds flew very high indeed. But after a while, many of them grew tired and could fly no longer, so they flew back to earth. The vulture saw a dead animal and was suddenly so hungry he dived down and out of the contest. Just a few birds were able to keep on flying. Eventually, the skylark and the dove came down too. They couldn't go any higher. In the end, they could see only one bird still up in the sky, so high that he seemed to be almost in heaven. It was the eagle. Finally, even he could fly no higher. Tired but proud, he hovered way, way up in the sky. "I knew I would win," he said to himself. But as the mighty eagle soared high above the earth, something crept out from under his thick feathers. To the eagle's amazement, he saw a tiny bird, the little wren, flying even higher than he was. He tried and tried to get above her, but he was too tired. "How did you fly so high?" he asked her. She laughed a tiny laugh because she was such a tiny bird. "You carried me all the way," she said. "I couldn't have flown so high by myself, but don't worry, you won the contest." "I always wondered what the world looked like from high, high up at the top of the sky. Now I know. I shall always remember this. Thank you." And when they got back to Earth, they told their story to the other birds. The owl praised them both. "Together you have set a new record," he told them. "With your strong wings and determination, mighty eagle, and with your dreaming and your quick brain, little wren, you have flown to a height never reached by any bird before." As Jane Goodall illustrates in her book, and as we often learn every moment of every day, none of us can fly very high by ourselves. We all need an eagle. We may need to be feathers on an eagle for others. We may need to be strong wing feathers beating the air to stay aloft. Others may be like the soft down feathers that nestle around you when you are tired. And like the feather on the eagle, each one of you is valued. Each one of you should be respected. Thank you, class of 2001, for what you have given to North Penn High School. May each of you continue to cherish your successes of the past and continue to build the successes of your tomorrows.
The world as we know it.
At this time, it's traditional to present a gift to the class. And as you may know, the class of 2000 likes to do things a little bit differently, and tonight's no different. We have a little present for you to wish you a sweet success. We'd like to thank all of you for sharing your true colors this evening. When we start, we'd like everyone to proceed from this side of the stage, across the stage, and down to receive their gift, starting the same way you proceeded in. So thank you so much, congratulations, and best wishes.
Thank you. show.